الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected brothers, dear sisters, Alhamdulillah, another day of these blessed days of the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it in our hasanat, inshallah, our siyam, our qiyam, our tasbih, our dhikr, our sadaqat, our iftar, whatever good deeds you are doing. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala count it, inshallah, and it will be in your good deeds, inshallah, and your sahifat al-a'mal, inshallah. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. Think with me, brothers, before Dr. Ibrahim, mashallah, is covering the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, jazallah khair, it's beautiful, mashallah. Before the ba'athah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before the coming of Rasulullah as a messenger, as a prophet of Allah, look at the people of Arabia in general. Subhanallah, you see, wa'di al-banat ahya, they used to bury the little girls alive. Subhanallah, mushkila. And tribes fighting each other for useless things. يعني أتفه الأسباب. You see a man from here, among the fighting, killing each other. Before Islam, subhanAllah, they used to worship al-asnam, the statues around the Kaaba. It's not, no benefit, no harm. Just statues. SubhanAllah. Riba, usury, with all types of usury, they used to deal with each other there. During, before Islam, all of this, subhanAllah. People making tawaf around al-Kaaba naked. The women, they were making tawaf around the Kaaba during the day naked, and women during the night naked also. Yeah, around the Kaaba. See how these people used to do. Yes, subhanAllah. وَمَا كَانَ صَلَاتُهُمْ عَنْدَ الْبَيْتِ إِلَّا مُكَاءً وَتَصْدِيلٍ. They used to whistling and clapping their hands. This is their salah around the Kaaba when they make tawaf. That's it, whistling and clapping. That's this how Arab people before Islam. Tabarruj, women naked, like nowadays or more. Shurb al-khumur, drinking al-khamr, like water. Lahu, ma'azif, singing, music, and instruments. All of this before Islam. And bilas, houses with the red flags. That homes or houses with red flags means for fornication and other things. Licensed, subhanAllah, they allow it. All of these before in Islam. Islam came to cleansing the society from all of this filth, subhanAllah. Tayyib. Who made that big change when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came? What did Rasulullah comes with? What did he came with? What did he comes with or come with sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He came with the Quran. The same Quran we are reciting for you. SubhanAllah, people are listening to 24/7, especially in the month of Ramadan. The question is, these people from that side, now look at bad things I mentioned it, they became Sahaba. What? Sahaba. And when we mention them, we say, Radiyallahu anhum. May Allah be pleased with them when we mention any one of them. Before Islam, they were killers. Khamr, drinking Khamr, addicted to Khamr. Umar bin Khattab himself, may Allah be pleased with him. Before Islam, was Jabbar al-Jahiliyyah, Jabbar al-Islam. SubhanAllah. See, when we mention their names, you say, Radiyallahu anhum. Why? Because they listened to the Quran. And the Quran al-Kareem changed their mind, their mental. Physically, spiritually, they became Sahaba, as I said. They carried this deen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا زِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. That's why we focus about the Quran this month. We focus more. If you notice my lecture before the Taraweeh every night, I call it the Quran, a guide, mercy and healing. And we explain some certain ayat from the Quran related to the subject. القرآن الكريم كان not can is able, capable to change your mind, to change this humanity to different people. سبحان الله. القرآن it's a message of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. It's كلام الله سبحانه وتعالى. فالقرآن it's شفاء. Look that hadith very famous hadith Imam al-Suyuti, he mentioned it in his book الإتقان في علوم القرآن. What did he say? Hadith al-Bukhari, Aisha رضي الله عنها, the mother of the believer, she said, look at this very important statement from Aisha رضي الله عنها أم المؤمنين about the Quran. Look what she said. إنما نزل أول ما نزل سورة من المفصل فيها ذكر الجنة والنار. First thing Rasulullah received from the Quran, that سورة from المفصل. المفصل هو like سورة قاف. This سورة here, you know, this is يعني if you say the Bara number like 28, 29 like this, you know, this is called مفصل. And this آيات مكية mentioning the الجنة, the hellfire. Talks about the creed, the faith, the عقيدة, the stories of the prophets. All of this, why? To plant the seed of Iman in the hearts of the mu'mineen, the people, their hearts. And she said, people, they came to Islam. They knew the rules and they knew the creed now, the faith. They learned the Iman. That's why Rasulullah, 13 years in Mecca, he was teaching the Sahaba al-Iman, the seeds of Iman first. 13 years after, mashallah, the Iman was growing. Their hearts, they went to Medina. What Medina happened? The ayat al-Madaniya. Ayat al-Madaniya what? Halal haram. Halal haram. Now you are ready to receive the rules. Yes, 13 years. Allah, Jannah, Hellfire, angels, the prophets of Allah, the stories, the messengers of Allah. See, to build up al-Iman in their hearts, to preparation for 13 years. But when they went to Medina, now halal haram. And Aisha, look what the statement, what she said. وَلَوْ نَزَلَ أَوَّلَ شَيْءٍ لَا تَشْرَبُ الْخَمْرِ. If the first thing in the Quran it was, don't drink alcohol, لَقَالُوا, they will say, لَا نَدْعُ شُرْبَ الْخَمْرِ. We'll never gonna leave the الخمر. See, because there is no iman to carry that. There is no iman. For Rasulullah who is putting iman in their hearts first, then when they get the iman, they can receive the rules. We can listen. سمعنا وأطعنا. See, she said, if the first thing in Islam, don't drink al-khamr, in the Quran, they will say, we're never going to drink, stop. وَلَوْ نَزَلَ أَوَّلَ شَيْءٍ لَا تَزْنُوا لَقَالُوا لَا نَدَعَ الزِّنَا. If the first ayat in the Quran, it was, don't make adultery, they said, we're never going to leave it. Because no iman. Iman will carry you, will carry you. That's why these people, Quran changed them. They became sahab like what I said. طيب, we are listening to the Quran. Why we are not changing? And the month of Ramadan is the month of التغيير, changing. And when we listen to the Quran, you have to change. سمعنا وأطعنا. Oh Allah, we listen and we obey. Jewish, they said, سمعنا وعصينا. We listen and we disobey. But the Muslim will say, سمعنا وأطعنا. وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا. ها الآيات اللي عنده في سورة البقرة. غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. الله سبحانه وتعالى said this Quran can change the mountain. That Quran, you put it in your side, beside your bed, in your car, in your bucket, in your phone. سبحان الله, around you. That Quran, if Allah revealed it to the mountain will crack, will collapse. Collapse. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون. فذات شوي القرآن الكريم the book of changing, especially شهر رمضان the month of القرآن. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى said this Quran هدى وبينات. And they said إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي أقوم. The Quran is not a book of science or math or anything like that, because I'm not against, but I don't like it, those who are talking about the miracles of the numbers of the Quran and all of that. They make the Quran like a mathematic book. The Quran is not a math book or science book. The Quran, it's a book of guidance. Who said Allah in Surah Al-Isra, verse number 9, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي. Indeed, this Quran is a guide, it's a mercy, it's a healing. يهدي للتي هي أقوى. It guides people to the straight path. ويبشر المؤمنين. ويبشر المؤمنين. It's giving glad tidings. good news to the mu'mineen, those who are making righteous good deeds, that they will have a great reward from Allah. أجراً كبيراً. What is the great reward from Allah? الجنة. الجنة. And لهم أجراً كبيراً. سبحان الله. And we recite سورة طه yesterday, last night. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said طه. By the way, طه is not رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. It's Sheikh Azir, he's the leader of the Qari in Egypt. He said Taha. Some Sufi they say Taha. Saha Sheikh. It's Taha is not Rasulullah. Yasin is not Rasulullah. These are the beginning of the Quran, الحروف المقطعة من القرآن. Saha Sheikh. Abu Ja'far, this one of the reciters, he's reciting it Taha. The two letters. Yes, it's not قراءة شاذة ولا حاجة. يا مزبوط. طا ها يا سين. ها مين سين. ليس الحروف المقطعة عند بيقول في القرآن. Yes. Some مفسرين طبعا it's I don't like this. يقول لك قاف it's a mountain. قاف is not a mountain. قاف it's a letter in the Arabic language. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى challenged the people of Mecca with this letter. Quran from these letters. Can you bring 10 آيات؟ سورة؟ One verse؟ Allah challenged them. ولن تفعلوا سبحان الله said that you cannot do it yeah. For the point here is Allah سبحانه وتعالى said طه two letters ما أنزلنا عليك القرآن لتشقى يا محمد we did not send the Quran to you to make your life miserable القرآن is سعادة happiness yes to make you happy and strong looking for happiness read the Quran الكريم وقال الذين كفروا لولا نزل عليه القرآن جملة واحدة كذلك لنثبت به فؤادك ورتلناه ترتيلا التوراة سيدنا موسى he received it one time the gospel the bible the same thing but the Quran الكريم الإمام السيوطي he said in his book علوم القرآن mostly رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم he received the Quran five verses by five verses mostly why first of all رسول الله was illiterate He did not write it, know how to read it. It's easy for him to get this ayat for some incidents. And he used to give it to Sahaba. Sahaba used to write it down. Subhanallah. Bilas Jibreel, he used to review the whole entire Quran with him every Ramadan. And the year when he before his death, he reviewed it twice in that Ramadan, last Ramadan, Sayyidina Jibreel, with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For the point here is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to give it to him. يعني سبحان الله يعني to make his heart firm سبحان الله and Allah سبحانه وتعالى said ولقد ضربنا للناس في هذا القرآن من كل مثل في هذا القرآن من كل مثل لعلهم يتذكرون said نحن أعلم بما يقولون وما أنت عليهم بجبار فذكر بالقرآن من يخاف وعيد يبقى القرآن it's a ذكرى an admonition reminder موعظة this what Allah سبحانه وتعالى said If you listen to this, what he said, to reflect, the Quran is not changing our mind and our hearts. We are listening. Sometimes you read the ayah, millions of times you never cry, you never tear, never affect your skin or your heart. Because we don't understand it. If you understand the Quran will melt, it will make you melt. Wallahi al-Azim. Sometimes I recite, I feel I'm shaking like this. My body is like that, but I'm trying to hold myself. والله القرآن يا جماعة is not easy الله سبحانه وتعالى is telling رسول الله إنا سنلقي عليك قولا ثقيلا one صحابي he was sitting and his leg was under the leg of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم جبريل came giving رسول الله القرآن صحابي he said I felt like a mountain above my leg was about to be broken سبحان الله yeah and you see رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم when جبريل used to come to him redness swearing redness on his face until he فسري عنه And while it was heavy like that, he said, Brother Jibreel, I love you, come often. I like you to come more because I love you. He said, I cannot come myself. وما نتنزل إلا بأمر ربك. لهم ما بين أيدينا وما خلفنا وما بين ذلك وما كان ربك نسيا. Jibreel said, يا رسول الله, I cannot come myself. I have to take permission before I come. He said, because I love you, come often. I want to sit with you. Well, it was so hard for رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم when he used to receive the revelation. فالقرآن الكريم, I don't want to make it long, Really, يا جماعة, we have to make some kind of a change. Look at this ayah in Surah Ra'd, the chapter of the thunder. I just finished its tafsir before Ramadan. Verse number 31. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَوْ أَنَّ قُرْآنًا سُيِّرَتْ بِهِ الْجِبَالِ أو قطعت به الأرض أو كلمة به الموتى، بل لله الأمر جميعا. إف ده مفسرين لسيدة إف it will be a Quran to move a mountain from its place or to cut the earth with it to pieces like that or to talk with the dead people with that Quran, it will be our Quran. This is the meaning of the ayah. It will be our Quran. See, the Quran can make too many things, but احنا we have to receive it in a good way. The sender and the signal must be in the same direction. Otherwise, Allah is sending the Quran and you are in different direction, you will never gonna receive it. You have to be in the same direction with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Read the Quran, not talk about halal and haram. You have to think about the Quran. You have to let this Quran comes to your heart. The jinn, when they listen to it, they hasten to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even when Surah Ar-Rahman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it to Rasulullah, فَبِأَيَّ أَلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. The jinn, they answered. Sahaba, they did not know what to say. Sahaba, they said, وَلَا بِشَيْءٍ مِنْ نِعْمِكَ يَا رَبِّ نُكَذِّبِ فَلَكَ الْحَمْدُ وَلَكَ الشُّكْرِ. We never deny any one of your bounties, ya Allah. And we are so grateful to you. Jinn, they answered the ayat. Rasul Sahib said to the Sahaba, don't you know? Don't you know how to answer like a jinn? Jinn, they answer you or not to the ayat of the Quran. That's why you have to reflect. You have to react with the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very important to think about this. Quran al-Kareem, can it change our life? Can it change our life to be good? Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Ameen. And I will finish with this. إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم وإذا تليت عليهم آياته زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. More you listen to the Quran, more your level of iman will go up. But when you listen to the Quran with your heart. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى said also, سورة النمل verse 91-92, إنما أمرت أن أعبد رب هذه البلدة الذي حرمها. رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم القرآن mentioned that. He said, I've been commanded to worship Allah, the Lord of Mecca, هذه البلدة الذي حرمها وله كل شيء, everything belongs to him. وأمرت أن أكون من المسلمين, I've been commanded to be a Muslim, first Muslim. What else? وأن أتلو القرآن. Allah commanded me to recite the Quran. وأن أتلو القرآن. فمن اهتدى فإنما يهتدي نفسه ومن ضل فقل إنما أنا من المنذرين. أم أسلم الله سبحانه وتعالى يجعلنا وإياكم من أهل القرآن وأن ينفعنا بالقرآن وأن يرفعنا بالقرآن وأن يجعله لنا في الدنيا قرينا وفي القبر مونسا وعلى الصراط نورا ويوم القيامة شفيعا ودليلا لجناتك يا رب, جنات النعيم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وسجدنا يا رب. يسر أمورنا يا من كتابنا واحفظنا جميعا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا وجعلنا لك من الشاكرين. أسألك يا ربنا من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله. وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خيرا وإياكم إن شاء الله.